Hello and welcome to another sound exploration. I finally had time to bring my modular synth to my studio to try it with drums and a Trott mic, and so I'll walk you through some of the sounds I made. This is a Trott microphone I built. It's a belt with two piezos inside. This is linked to the Converter E1 module by Sonic Smith, which converts audio to CV, and then I can control parameters or sounds in the synth. The first sound I made was with plats, and so the CV from the Trott is going to the timbre parameter in Platts, which makes it glitch depending on the note I'm doing in my throat. So I was playing drums and I was at first kind of speaking just to send different CV levels to it. And so here's how it sounds. So I'll bring up Platts gradually. This is Platts. So you can hear that when I'm speaking, it affects the timbre. And while playing, I realized that what was more fun than singing notes was making rhythms or just sounds with my mouth. Kind of in this way, and so this became one of the textures. So the second sound I used was the direct sound from the microphone, so the piezos in my throat, and here's how it sounds.
This is my throat. This is my throat.
And I put Ocht on the gain with a very fast LFO, like this, so that I could... So it would make that this type of sound, and I had split the CV that I control my throat to control the speed of Ocht. So it was going at different speeds depending on the note I sing. A third sound I made was with the internal synth of the Converter E1 module. So this is how it sounds. So as you can see, the pitch tracking is pretty good. And if I remember correctly, I put it an octave higher. So when I would speak, so that I could sing. And this was sent to the reverb. So I had the main textures of Platts and the direct sound from the throat with the LFO. And in the background, I had the synth control for my voice in the lushness of the reverb. So just a last example with the since I'm not that comfortable singing, so I think the more fun I got was when I went more into the effects, and so thinking about the throat control more as the way to affect parameters of certain modules rather than a synth voice. So I think I'll go in this direction for next time. The other thing I had going on in the patch was some movement on the gain, some movement on the pan. I also had the bass drum triggering sounds from Zadar, like the bass note that comes in about at the middle of the video. And I was also playing with the FX end going to the reverb, and the reverb was going through its own FX end to the data bender, so I could add glitches based on the reverb. So that's it for the patch. I hope you enjoyed the performance and the explanation. I'll make more videos soon combining both and explore more with the throat microphone. So that's it for now. Thank you. Bye.